Alright, welcome to the first match. Our opponent is on the play and currently mulliganing to 6. We're going to keep this hand. First of all, it's got Mox Opal, which is just a single Baskar in the deck. And second of all, it's missing a little bit of action. If we draw a Master or Steel Overseer or Plating, I'll be very happy. But so we still got Signal plus Man Lands and quite a fast start, so it's still a good keep. We're going to lead with... Oh, we got Ravager. This is one of the cards I forgot to mention, but this Ravager is a great card in this hand. I'm going to lead with Inkmuth because this is more likely that I will poison him, especially because of Ravager. Play Mox. And here we have the choice between Signal Pest or Ravager. Because it's you usually don't sack stuff super early, I'm thinking that I might want to play Signal Pest first. It's actually a scenario that hasn't happened recently, so I'm not too sure. I feel like playing Ravager is usually just a better play because it's just better on the mana, and it's also it also protects a little bit from removals. But here, against a Birds deck, I don't think he's going to have many removals. Signal Pest gets in for a little bit more, although he might have a Ground Blocker. And if he does, then like pumping my Mem... I might not even attack with Memnite. Although I want to attack with Ornithopter. But although I really want to attack with the Nexus next turn, so... Yeah, I think I'm still just going to play Ravager. Visitors here. Okay, so we're playing against Milira Company. And he's got quite a good start. So we're not going to be able to poison him because of Milira. And our Inkmuth Nexus, assuming it works as it should on Magic Online, Inkmuth Nexus actually doesn't do anything with a Milira in play. There's some weird rulings that makes Milira completely shut down Inkmuth. It doesn't have infect, and it also just can't deal normal damage. I don't know why exactly, but I just know that's how it works. You can Google it or whatever, but I assure you that this is how it works. I'm gonna play Blinkmuth, and I'm gonna definitely want to attack with Memnite because I don't really care if he blocks anything. Well, I do want him to block something. I'll play the Signal Pest. I didn't tap the right land, but it should matter because I'm not going to block. I'm going to attack with these. Oh, that was actually terrible. For some reason, I was thinking that my Ravager was still... not my Ravager, but I thought for some reason that I took the line of playing a Signal Pest the turn before, so my mana would be 2-1. So this attack actually just doesn't make any sense. But I would still sack stuff to my Ravager in this spot, and then I believe sacking Memnite is probably okay. I definitely want to sack the Inkmuth. So activate it. Sack it. And well, I definitely have to sack Memnite. But I think I might have still done the same play. I'm not gonna sack the Thopter, but yeah. So yeah, it was kinda dumb because like now I can't block and I can't block an Ornithopter. I shouldn't really have attacked with it. And shouldn't have attacked with Memnite either, but I think I would have sacked the Memnite. So that's probably fine. It shouldn't matter. Okay, so he didn't hit Kitchen Finks. So we're not gonna die just yet. Okay, so you would have, if you made this attack before. Okay, so my terrible attack that just was completely just a brain fart ended up not mattering. I'm gonna play the stop there. Play Nexus. Tap and activate this Nexus. Attack. This, and this. Okay, so he blocks the Ravager. That's fine by me. He's gonna scry. Put a card in bottom, so that's good news. Down to 13. And we pass. It's not impossible that he would be able to somewhat race us, because he has an ooze. We have two creatures in the graveyards, and Prime Mage is a good one. And also, it makes him gain life, and he can just chum block with a few things, effectively just pumping his ooze every time he chumps. I'm thinking here I could block the ooze, but I'm not. I'm gonna save it for later, I think. I don't have to block right away. Another Visitor Seer. Not exactly what we want, but it's better than Glimmer Void. So I'm gonna activate one Nexus for sure. And possibly another one. So he's probably gonna kill the Signal Pest. Yeah, I'm just gonna activate the other one. Like, I'm not gonna die to his attack on this turn anyways. At least I don't think. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, he can't kill us. So I'm not gonna keep blockers that turn. It's not too bad here because we can eat it. And he has to block Ravager. What am I doing? I just attacked with Ornithopter again. And it just doesn't make any sense. I might be still a little tired from my GP this weekend. It was exhausting. And I just came back, and we're currently Tuesday. Yeah, so that is extremely stupid. It's gonna take 2, go down to 10. Yeah, attacking with Ornithopter is so bad this turn, because I would have wanted to chomp next turn. Maybe I want to put a few things on an Ornithopter. He has no cards in hand. So if I put, let's say I sack two Ornithopters and I put everything on a Nexus, he would take 6, 7, be down to 5. Next turn he would chump and gain life. Yeah, it's not worth it just yet. Like, I might end up losing the race here because I attacked with Ornithopter for no reason. And you just put a card on top with Visitor Seer, so it might also just not matter because it could be Cord or Company, and then... Okay, it's Company. Let's hope he doesn't hit anything too good. Witness and Spellskite. Okay, so we are pretty much dead because he's going to get back Company or Prime Mage. And he has a Spellskite, which means we can't move Ravager counters around. Now he gets to attack for 4. Down to 9. Master is a good draw. I'll play it. It's gigantic. So I kind of have to hope he whiffs with the... kind of have to hope he whiffs with his company. I'm gonna activate a Nexus. Attack with these, and maybe I keep one Ornithopter. So that puts him, he's gonna chump with Witness. Take three, do it down to six. Next turn. Yeah, maybe I can attack with Ornithopter here. Gonna chum, take four, go down to five, and then I get getting much closer to killing him. Because I don't think I'm gonna block with that Ornithopter anyways. Like here, I can block with Master. He doesn't really have a good way to kill the Master, so I'm gonna block. Let's say Ooze, I take five. Yeah, I can't really die, so I'm gonna attack with these. So despite playing not great, we're not getting punished, so it is not too bad so far. Put a card in bottom. So we basically need him to whiff for a third time with company on Kitchen Finks. Kind of ridiculous, but maybe that's our lucky day. He's gonna try and scry Sacks to Who, so he's going all in on the try to find Kitchen Fix plan. He put a card in bottom, he just cried. Now he's cry spell sky, put a card in bottom again. Yeah, he's going all in, which I think is a good play here. Because I have flyers and stuff, he's not going to race me with the ooze, and he's also strain all mana a little bit, so he can't play spells, can't play company and put stuff in ooze. Now he's going to try to company again. And he got a Finx. Alright, so we're going to scoop here. I'm not going to let him combo, because that's just mean. Alright. I'm gonna board in Whip Flare, Gut Shot. We want Cages. Cages are fantastic in this matchup. Grid is good, but not insane. Dispatch is good, especially against Sphinx. Welding Jar is mediocre. They usually have Stony Silence, so I'm gonna board out at least two Steel Overseers. Master is great, they don't really have good removals. They might have Abrupt Decay, so I'm going to keep at least one Welding Jar. Memnite is mediocre because it's a creature, a ground creature, and they have a bunch of blockers. So we have these two cages, a Gotcha, and a Whip Flare. Etch Champion is not really a card I want in this matchup. They're not really... If they had like Lingering Souls or they were trying to play a more fair game, I would, but I don't think that's the that's their plan. They are mostly, they're still gonna try to combo me, and I just don't think it's worth it. Sure, they go more they're gonna have like Pontiff and maybe like another Prime Mage or a Calamity Mage and Sage. They're gonna have Stony Silence, Abrupt Decay, maybe Path. They're going a little bit more hard on the removal and in a sort of grindy game. But I still think it's not enough that it's worth that I board in Edge Champions. I don't think. Maybe it's better than Master. But they have like four removal at best after sideboard, so I'm a little skeptical. Maybe I want to board out another Memnite, or maybe just Jar. Maybe they only really have Abrupt Decay. I guess they have Prime Mage, which they can find easily. But on the play, yeah, on the play, maybe it's possible that Master is just better because it's more punishing. Steel Officer is usually good in any creature matchups, but the ones that have Stony Silence, it gets a little bit worse. I could even see myself boarding out a few more for Edge Champion, but the difference between 2 and 3 mana is a real thing. I'll try 1 my might out for Edge Champion. Let's go 3 and 2. I'm not completely sure here. Play first. This is not a hand we can keep. This is a batter, but it's still pretty poor. But I think with a scribe, pretty much have to keep. Doesn't have any of the sideboard cards, but it's got dispatch, so it's probably okay. If I draw like Darksteel Citadel here or Mox, it gets much better. Alright, our opponent kept 7. And we scry. Okay, so we got Signal Pass. Is Signal Pass something I want to keep? We're going to play turn 1, Drum. Turn 2, I'm going to play Vold Scourge and another Vold Scourge. So, yeah, I don't really want this Signal Pass. I could go like second turn Vold Scourge and Pest. But I just think I can get a better card than this. Mana Source would be nice. So the reason I don't really want to play Vault Scourge on turn 1 here is... I guess this is true for Signal Pest. Like, if you have Signal Pest and Drum, you definitely want to play Drum first because the Signal Pest doesn't do anything. But I think there's a chance that I want to attack with the Vold Scourge and then play Drum, and then if I drew Mana Source, I can tap my land, play Vold Scourge. No, in any case, I'm not gonna attack. But I guess it doesn't matter because it's not gonna influence whatever he does, so might as well just represent attacking. It just doesn't matter really here. Random Forgender, interesting. Okay, so we're gonna play that Drum. We're gonna tap this, pay 2 life, play another Vold Scourge. So he's boarding in Branton in fear of Whip Flare, but I only have 1, so I guess I'm somewhat happy he does that. Ooh, that's gonna be harsh. Okay. So I'm gonna have to sack one of the Vold Scourges. I'm gonna dispatch Kataki. So I'm gonna float. Okay, I know this is this one. So I'm gonna tap this one for a white. Dispatch the Kataki. Now this is this Vold Scourge, which we don't want to keep. Now I have the choice between keeping my Vold Scourge or my Drum. And I think I want to keep my Vold Scourge. Or maybe my Drum, because then next turn I can go, if I draw Atlantic, go Vold Scourge or Drum, or I can, if I don't draw Atlantic, just play Vold Scourge and next turn play Ravager, which puts me in a really bad spot either way. And now if I keep my Vold Scourge, I basically get to absolutely kind of need to draw land in the next two turns. Whether now or next draw step. And I think I want to take the risk of drawing lands. Yeah, I think I'm going to take that risk. Although this is a colored source and it's not negligible. Yeah, I'm going to keep the draw. Maybe the Vulture is not relevant enough. Nah, I can't keep the drum. I'm gonna keep the Vault Scourge and go for the a little bit more greedy line. I would like to pay one to prevent this, and I cannot pay for this. Darksteel, no. Alright, we'll attack for one. He's got two auras and canopy, so I guess there's still a chance we could beat him down. Oof. This is not going well. Pontiff. He drew all of his one-ups that are insane against us. I guess Barantan is not insane, though. And even that Pontiff is not even that insane here, but it's still really good. Play Ravager. Pass. And he pats it. I mean, that's... It kind of helps me a little bit. I'm not unhappy to trade Ravager for a land in this spot. Cord for four. That's Linvala, maybe? Yeah. We're getting ranched. Play this. So it gives it two power, which is enough to kill the 1/1s, I guess. Or I can play an 0/1. 0/1 just doesn't do much. Equip this. Oh, he's at 8. I didn't realize that. Yeah, I'll just play Signal Pest. What is a company? Sure. Fangs and a Witness, which is going to buy back either Path, Cord, or Company. I would guess that he gets back Cord. Okay. Yeah, Cord is fine. He can Cord that turn. He can Cord for four again. Got another plating, which now I can attack with. I guess I attack with Signal Pest. Play the plating. I'll attack with Ornithopter. Now, well, I guess you can Cord for Prime Mage, eat my plating, and then my Thopter. And I'll just pass. For one, and that means he has Milero or Nefanza in his hand. Okay. Alright, well, we got completely destroyed. So I'll see you for another match.